Welcome to the Esports Canada TV Finals here at the Invictus Game Station down in Canada, Toronto. We've got Team Green.
Why would
Green.
It be down in Canada? Canada's on top of everything else.
I'm assuming everyone lives in Nunavut who's watching this stream.
Well, that's Canada too. Whatever.
It's welcome, cool. Ladies and gentlemen. We've got Team
welcome.
Green up against Team Ruby.
Ruby on the red side, Green on the blue side.
If you guys are in the chat are fans of MIMO, and wanted Team Red to make it through. Team Green are the ones who have eliminated him.
Took him downtown.
Nevertheless,
that too.
Splice beat H2K in the Game 5 series.
I really like that fight. So
Immortals versus Cloud9 is what's being played right now. But the reason why you are all here is due to the solo queue summer hero. You're not here for no LCS. You're here for Toronto's
best top, and brightest.
Best and brightest, the top priority of action. We've got ourselves a little bit of a pick and ban phase underway.
And Cassidy. The target ban, this is three mid bans toward Misha Swamp.
That's what I like to see.
Yeah, he just played Xerath, got MVP in that match. Matter of fact, that barn burner.
Nidalee, AKA Nidalee.
I
know people say Shaco, Shaco.
Well, it's Shaco because it's also Faco, right? Ooh, Nex is busting out. Sorry, Gray. The name change. Gray with the LeBlanc. This has been banned.
To be honest with you, this is going to be Misha Swamp's hardest matchup throughout this entire tournament. This will be a true test of skill as to whether or not he can carry his team. Will be, you know, in full-fledged readiness to face off against Gray.
LeBlanc is one of Gray's best champions by far. LeBlanc and Syndra both have been target banned against him, not only in this tournament, but in pretty much every other tournament he's played, every other solo queue hero, solo queue legend tournament. Looks like another Gragas and another Janna, both of them very popular in this tournament here today.
Well, LeBlanc's sure gonna have a fun time against the two disengaged masters.
Yeah, tell me about it. Both of those champions have huge potential to get in the way of this LeBlanc. I can only imagine that if they picked the Syndra to ban over the LeBlanc, they had a plan to counter the LeBlanc. Counter the LeBlanc. And I am very interested to see what happens.
Covered, but it's almost certain that he'll be picked up. But you know what? I don't like it when there's like, let's say, don't like it when there's a meta. But it seems like
there's always a tournament meta.
Yeah,
I'm surprised we haven't seen more Caitlyn. That seems to always be the tournament. I've seen a couple of Caitlyn games, but I feel like Caitlyn is always in the tournament meta. So, that's what we hear.
There we go. At least it wasn't muted.
At least it wasn't muted. The desktop audio was playing, so it might have been a little bit loud for you guys. Our sincerest apologies. So this Teemo hover is annoying. I don't want to look at this rat face.
It's a classic hover. It's a classic.
Yeah,
hover.
It's backfired way too many times this season in Pro League. That
it was an accidental Rammus pick by Piglet in one of the games.
Yeah.
That was fun. That was like an
and that was that yeah, and that was like the match too. That was going to decide whether or not they made it to the LCS.
Yeah.
And then they had to go to the promotion tournament and lost to Echo Fox, I believe it was. My boys on Echo Fox.
I feel sorry for Echo Fox. But that's a story for another day.
So it seems actually at this point that Ruby going for a very similar composition to what they did last time. Last time they had the Graves in the jungle. This time the Gragas. But apart from that, identical comp with the Sivir, Janna, and
Sion, Lucian. This is a pretty standard composition. We're going to have to see how these guys use these characters. Oh, Jhin. Oh. I'd love to see it.
I do love to see it.
Make me happy.
such a strong champion right now. Having so much fun.
Come on, Wild Turtles playing Toronto Hype. Let's
go. It is. The young Yak who we saw pop off on Singed, or Singed, Twitch, the other toxic champion.
Earlier today. Variety of AD carries.
Indeed. Indeed he does.
Misha going with the classic Orianna pick.
Mm-hmm. Which, if they had a plan to deal with Philip Long, I'm not seeing it. They're just like, we want a hardcore team fight, get some spicy Renekton Gragas flanks on the back line and just clean them up. Maybe. I'm not really sure what they're trying to accomplish with this just yet. We'll have to see what their final lock-in is for Misha's one.
Do you think Ray will
likely, but only to the bottom side. It's not really worth snowballing Sion. Honestly, it's, you know, you generally don't really benefit from having a super fed Sion. You never heard about the Sion hyper carry.
It's true.
Well, maybe you have, but I certainly haven't. Orianna is going to be the final lock-in. This isn't the first Orianna we saw today. We saw one earlier today.
By Misha Swamp
when they played green in this very matchup. When they were playing the same team earlier today in the first game of the day, and they got absolutely demolished by the Victor Twitch Malphite combo.
That's interesting that they face each other.
Face each other in the first finals. Game of the day, and now they're facing each other in the finals. Congratulations to both these teams for making it so far, of course. And congratulations to Team Gold, who I got word actually took home the third place match.
They beat Red?
Red had to forfeit as a couple of their players had to leave.
Oh.
So, well, congratulations to Gold for
third
place.
If they had to leave, then they are not worth the finals. Because if they had to leave now, they wouldn't really be playing the finals. They'd forfeit the finals, technically
Indeed.
Speaking, right?
True.
And then we'd go home
enough.
Earlier. So why is Red not in the finals?
All right, Simo. That's enough of that. So I'm just sitting here on my lovely list here.
This tournament has been sponsored by.
Hasn't at all.
Hasn't.
It's been sponsored by me. Sponsored by my stream. If anybody would like to check out mine or Simo's stream, feel free to do so.
Considering that this is the finals, this is what I'm going to plug something, a little something.
Well, we got 2 minutes to wait. And you know what? Here, let me. I'll in chat real quick. I'll just type it in here.
Type it in your Twitch and type in my Twitch.
Crepe, or feel free.
I am doing a
27 hour stream of obscure.
I am doing a 24-hour stream, ladies and gentlemen, coming up on August 26th. That's pretty much less than a week from now. It's 6 days from now. It'll be on August 26th, starting at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. If you're not watching this from anywhere along the East Coast of America, if you're watching this on the West Coast, it might be 5 o'clock Pacific Standard Time. You know, I'm just ballparking here, so I'm not sure. Nevertheless, August 26th, starting at 8 p.m. to August 27th, finishing at 8 p.m., there's going to be every 2 hours a Steam card giveaway, because I don't know how many people like League of Legends, so I'm not going to give RP cards. If one person in the chat says, hey, can you get an RP card, I will throw in 3 RP cards. I'll throw them in. And if you can't make it to the stream, there will be another link somewhere on my stream. There's like a grand prize. Yeah, that's it. There will be a grand prize of a $50 Steam card and a copy of Dead by Daylight. So if you just ignored everything I said, August 26th, 8 p.m. is when the 24-hour stream starts.
I'm not going to do that. But I do stream sometimes, and it's almost always League of Legends.
I stream everything but League of Legends. Because this game has tilted me.
Has ruined you.
It's ruined me.
Has absolutely ruined
me. Also, I'm just like not like the meta hasn't really changed in my opinion for the past couple months.
Fair enough.
The past two seasons has been rough and tough, and I've been riding it out.
Well, that's enough of the plugs, because boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, we are getting into game one of the finals here at Soliq Summer Hero. I'm jazzed. Are you jazzed?
Hands. Jazz hands.
Going to transition to loading screen in 3, 2. Oh, I juked you out. I was did it at 2 instead of 1.
Oh.
Just so I could sit back a little bit. Nice. Good stuff.
Can you imagine if there was a Hextech scandal? Hextech Lotto? And there was
what?
Can you imagine if, like... Oh, snap. That was actually hella fast.
Hella fast.
Hella fast. No, I was saying, you know how there's like a scandal for the CSGO Lotto?
Yeah.
Can you imagine if there was a Hextech Lotto? Hextech Crate Lotto?
I mean, yeah, but you can't buy crates from their players. You can only buy crates from Rito themselves.
All right, look at this invade. This yeah, is this gonna is be stylish. I'm ready.
5 into the bottom lane. With Gray kind of chilling in the back a little bit.
They will get spotted out by the ward, so this is kind of...
Yeah, that's actually a really good ward. Spotting all 5 of them.
Moving as a unit. Ooh.
Gonna try
Why
and
did Sion
get
split off there? That's really... What is going on?
I'm not really sure.
They see everything. This is really yeah. good information for Team Ruby.
Absolutely.
Hey,
and they didn't have to.
I will.
Minions have spawned.
Danky Nugs, young Danky Nugs.
Young
in chat.
Danky, rest in peace, fifth
Welcome,
place.
Welcome, my friend. Yes. Sorry, you got. Sorry, you got destroyed, my man.
You know, he got shafted by the KDA rule, which is the team that
they agreed.
A tie.
It's People true. Agreed. You did have a spicy dragon game, though. I did see that. That was pretty spicy.
Danky,
but whatever. We're not worrying him. We don't care about. We don't care about Danky Nugs in his game. I mean, we care about you, Danky. We do. But right now, it's all about this game right here. Renekton versus Sion, Graves versus Gragas, LeBlanc versus Orianna, Jhin versus Sivir, Braum versus Kanna. What's your favorite matchup to play in the bottom?
I like Thresh into Karma.
Thresh into Karma?
Into Karma.
Okay.
It's a skill matchup. Because Karma almost has it like almost has a similar range as Thresh. Actually, Thresh is a little bit longer than Karma.
Karma's auto attack range is 475 or 450?
I'm talking about like the Q range.
Oh, okay.
Because that's like really where it's going to come down.
Ooh, nice little juke there.
I also like Alistar into anything because I like learning how to be a better Alistar. And,
yeah, you do love yourself some Alistar.
I forget what's the hardest matchup for Alistar to face, but... Usually, if you get level 2 and they don't respect it, oh my god, when they don't respect it, I have a huge shove, dude. Like, it's just...
Oh,
it's,
boy.
It's
oh,
it's so good.
Oh.
And the best part is when they let you walk up to them and you get level 2. Oh my god.
Yeah,
they
and
just
then
get,
you just Q them, and they're like, oh no! And then
god.
You W them under tower.
Like, literally, I start yelling, because I'm like, you did not respect me at all.
I feel like the hardest match for Alistar is probably, like, a Nami.
I'd probably say, like... Maybe
not your Braum is actually a difficult match.
Ooh,
first gank in the top lane.
Good body slam. Good stuff.
Nice flash. Gets himself out safely. But nice to see some patient.
Wow, that's spell shield. This is a Toronto's whoa, Gray.
Nice shield, actually.
That's a little bit of a gray area. You're gonna put yourself killed there if you play too aggressive.
Grave Shields actually, even in the first game when they got, pretty destroyed by Green. Misha's shields are one thing that were very good, consistently there.
He's a fantastic Orianna player, but Peter Lelol is in a little bit of trouble. Ouch. Man, I want to learn how to play Jhin so bad.
Jhin is very fun.
Seems like he's hard to learn, is he?
It's hard to get used to, yeah. With the reload mechanic
and whatnot. You're not like a real AD carry. That's an imaginatory AD carry. You don't exist.
Imaginatory? Is that what you just said? Imaginatory?
Yeah, I'm not on my game today. The monster
still
like
asleep.
Slightly woke me up, but it's like all those freaking siege comps and
there was one siege comp.
30-minute.
There was one.
30-minute is when the fights start. Like that's when I fall asleep.
I respect it.
But I gotta say that Kled made the day.
There's no Kled in this game.
One Kled. One
Sion's Kled. Ult is kind of like Kled.
Yeah,
doesn't make the same sound.
Yeah, he just gets super angry and has a period while he's running. Like he's like, oh, like that's Sion. Did you see the new splash work for Sion?
I did not.
It looks really good.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Looks really good.
I was unawares.
Like all the skin. Not the
all the skin ones? As in their skin changes?
No, the skin is staying the same.
The skin splashes.
The skin splashes.
Okay. Cool, cool, cool.
I actually really like this matchup because this is Renekton's first time against somebody who can actually like fight him. Like all the other people who have all the other champions. Okay, well maybe. This is.
Yeah, Sion does not go even with Renekton.
All right, this. Oh.
Oh my God, the fervor Renekton, the solo kill.
Oh my God, I literally ate my words way too soon. I was like, you know what, this guy can go toe to toe, and then.
Sion does not go even.
Look
Ooh,
at
nice.
Isha's swamp, man. Holy. Styling on a challenger player. Feels Kled, man.
Very nice. That feel when you get early ganked. That feel when your Orianna has lost chapter already, but you are all still out of mana. You need to level up. Going even so far with the LeBlanc.
Oh, the disrespect though, just body slams right into a Gragas. That is where I like to see.
Is it?
Yeah, dude.
Are you a fan of disrespectful players?
I'm one. I haven't been banned yet though. I refuse to share the same tree as Dagny does.
How are you gonna talk bad ish?
Danky knows I love him. Danky knows there's much love. I was the only one.
He's crying in chat.
I was hyping him up so much today. Every time I saw him in the hallway, I was like, let's go! And he lets go do that. That's love.
Wow, my guy.
But Demonic Kuma is about to show Peter Lalol what love is all about. Falling dangerously low. Ooh, there's the Protect. Wow, that's spicy.
Cheeky little bugger.
Sriracha sauce on that river, dude. Like, he just styled on that Renekton. Gave him the collateral damage to the face.
The 1-2.
The one.
The razzle and the dazzle.
Juke and the puke. That's a new one.
Juke and the puke?
Juke and the puke. You will learn. Listen, let me tell you a story about X-Temperess, all right?
Tell me.
X-Temperess comes to every tournament.
X-Temperess is also a very good support player.
I see. But I've seen her grow. She started off, you've seen her like one of her very first, some of her first tournaments, like a year ago, top. And she's never been like the most like top tier, like amazing player, but she's definitely stepped it up over the years. And you know what? Gotta say, this is why I love solo queue hero, because people like Gray, although you know not every challenger player that comes to these tournaments is like the nicest or always tells the truth that their duo is not a superior, but like these challenger diamond players teach these lesser, you know, not as strong players how to shot call, how to think, what the mind process is. And as you can see, X-Temperess can go toe-to-toe with some of the best supports in Toronto.
Absolutely.
And as a result, you see someone grow. Like, me and Jax are always talking about how some of these silvers turn into, like, platinum players
when they're when they're being told what to do by or not being told what to do necessarily.
Directed.
Being, when they're being directed by like a player like Mimo. We were talking about this earlier. Mimo on Team Rocket. Their team had to leave play the fourth grade match. Mimo is so good at directing his team. So sure, he may not have the highest elo players, or maybe he's just players. Anyway,
flash
Dragon.
On flash, Peter Lalol! And Vicious Swamp turning around like an apple turnover. Peter Lalol continuing to chase. There's the damage, there's the turret shot. Will Misha Swamp turn things around? No, he's
gonna
back away.
That is not how I expected that to go. Orianna just solo killed LeBlanc.
I'm telling you.
Wow.
Misha Swamp is the new... Is the future of Challenger players in Toronto.
Very, very impressive. Dirty LeBlanc player. Yeah, that was... Yeah, that is... Was a banana? Yeah, that was a banana. There you go.
This guy's... Okay. What if... Let's hypothetically say... Big Ban removed.
I mean, you gotta think they'll do that eventually, right?
There's like one game, like, still go to game three. I don't think they'll ban Renekton. I don't think people think he's much of a threat, but he's there every single game.
Yeah, and he's solo kill. I think he's gotten a solo kill on that top lane every single game.
Just get him off his comfort pick. What's he gonna pick? Like, never, they let him have Renekton every single time.
Absolutely. Yeah, when is going for the very snowball build, got a flash.
Yeah, when I play solo queue hero, I get double banned as a support main. Like, you know, like, life's tough. Can't get this guy can't get a Renekton ban, but I get Alistar and Nautilus banned.
I've been,
missed the body slam and missed the cask! What the banana?
That was super unlucky.
Super super unlucky.
That wasn't even, there's no super
it's just a gray area.
That was, like, honestly... Like, they didn't even blow flashes.
They didn't.
Body slammed into minions and then casked.
He just stand behind Bromd away.
Lag,
and
yeah. Lag. Unlucky. This Jhin is 50 CS up on Caesar.
Which is not how that match can go, I don't think.
Jhin is quite good into Sivir.
I just thought Sivir likes to clear, right?
Yeah, Sivir should be pushing the wave.
Maybe she's, there's no vision for that. Maybe that's why she's kind of playing really different. Look at that pink ward coverage, dude. That's, like, intense. Like, this freaking Ruby team wants to win. Actually, no. I'm talking about green. This green team wants to win that ball really hard.
Connected.
Wow.
Nice splash. Great.
Demonic Haruma.
That was an excellent reactive flash. Wow, that spell shield didn't look like it actually worked. Demonic Karuma going back in, despite the fact that LeBlanc just around the corner. Karuma, my man. You gotta get out of there, buddy.
Wait, he's got this. Look at the squad. The squad rolling up. They're stuck between the turret. Oh, baby. There's the body slam. Absolute decimation. Gray gets double killed by the Renekton. Peter Lelol is in a little bit of trouble. Shut down. Goes on to the Renekton. Yak in the bot lane, turning this around. There's the. Curtain Call. Same thing. You know, Eminem made both albums. Peter Lelol is on the run now. Misha Swamp turns things around. The distortion. I keep saying wrong spell. I'm not even on it today. Nevertheless, that was a good play. They get a good collapse on that top lane. Gray is 2-0-2. Not very impactful.
Peter Lelol. Gray is 0-2.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
Zero.
That's what I meant.
And this Renekton again is popping off.
It's true. It's popping off like prepubescent. It's popping off.
Oh
my. Oh no. When you flash, but you're dead. Feels cled, man. When you flash, but you're already dead.
Gray.
Oh my god. Feels cled, man.
finally doing something. Like, was just falling so far behind. Was having his roam smash. That is an unwarranted, undeserved Mastery 5. Not necessarily you do not deserve to be a Mastery 5 on that championship. You're not seeing Hunter to be flashing that after how hard you ended up losing this lane. And you should be pretty dominant, in my opinion.
I think there'll be a Renekton ban next game. There has to be. There's no way you can use all your bans on Gray. There's no way. Look, Misha has shown that he can beat Gray in lane. He's confident.
I mean, using. You got that backwards. If you use all your bans on Gray, it doesn't matter because the Renekton's on the other side. You tried your best.
Yeah.
All your bans on Misha.
The monster's still kicking in. The monster's
right.
still kicking
it's all right.
in. The monster's still kicking in. I just know that both teams banned out a lot of mid laners.
Yes, there's a lot of mid lane bans.
The
bans were Nidalee, Viktor, Syndra, Kassadin, Lissandra, and Zerah.
Yeah, no.
So that's three, four out of five.
They don't need to ban out Misha. They should ban out one of the Renekton.
Yeah, if Misha's like fourth best mid laner is Orianna, and he's playing it this well, don't bother banning him.
Yeah, you should let go
get
of that
Sivir. Get the Sivir, which is going to come for pick.
Let go of Lissandra or Zerah.
I mean, Lissandra we haven't seen. But like, let go of that Sivir comfort pick. Let go of the Renekton, or get rid of the Renekton. Get rid of the Sivir.
Ooh, great dodge from Kid of the Lord. Wow, great monsoon onto Yak. There's the shockwave, where it's not actually gonna do a whole lot. Yak's in a little bit of trouble. Gonna get collapsed on. Tries to turn it around on to the Sivir, but not gonna be enough damage. And it's crafting in the top lane, fighting off against demonic Kuruma, and he's actually gonna be taken dangerously low.
But it is a sign, full sign fire cape, so he's not. Too worried about.
Wow, there's the ultimate from Sion. He's gonna turn around with another knockup, but that stun cleans right. up shop like a janitor. What's going on with the other screen? I'm not too sure. Gray on the run, gonna get body slammed by. Oh, what's going on? Will he turn it around?
He's got one HP.
Oh, this is it. The flash cleans
the
up
flash
shop.
Bop. Flash bop. That is the moment when you flash your master emote as LeBlanc.
Feels okay.
I got flash bop. Oh, that spell shield on you is amazing. LeBlanc.
Oh no, Peter, how dare you? Killing spree.
I thought Peter wasn't actually going to get that kill, and I was like, that's going to tilt you off the face of the earth. But it looks like Gragas and Orianna are going to be able to get this first brick blood, first brick gold for Ruby.
You know what I wish?
What do you wish?
That the Riot streams had a sub button, and they made emotes. So it could be like League Twitch emotes. I think that'd be pretty neat. But that would be like capitalizing.
Yeah, I think it's a. They can. I don't think they can have a.
Because they have Facebook emotes.
Yeah, but you don't pay to look at them on Facebook. Unless you do, in case, don't. Tower number two. Going over.
So far, Ruby has been doing a fantastic job, but there's no real gold lead. Have a special celebrity guest coming into to the casting room.
Is that the one and only Dave?
It's Lil Dicky's entourage coming in. He actually was one of the prop developers for Save That Money. He helped with the yacht. That was his job. He helped with the yacht.
Because he provided his own yacht.
No. He's got a yacht. Yeah. He's got a esports yacht.
It was his esports money.
Esports yacht. There's an esports bar in Toronto. There's also an esports yacht, courtesy of
Dave Craig.
Endersword. Coming in clutch. We got some info in the chat. Don't let Misha play Lee, Sliss, Cass, or Zerath. They're going to ban the same bans. He's much weaker on Ori than the Big Three.
He's much weaker on Ori than the big three, but one lane against.
So that's what you were saying. Oh, baby. Look at that shockwave. Gray's in a little bit of trouble. The explosive cast makes things a little bit messy. Disrupts the fight. both teammates are just going to peel off. They might collapse. They've got the vision to collapse on Haruma.
Graves is balanced. Low. Graves is balanced. Real unlucky. Rift Herald has returned to the void. No Rift Herald buff for Renekton.
They just didn't have the time, I don't think.
There was a couple opportunities they could have, but
yeah. Peter Lelol. Ooh. He's dancing with the he's dancing the pink ward dance. Wow. They just keep poking. Neither of them are a poke comp, but they keep poking each other. Wow, Gray finding himself in a little bit of trouble. He doesn't have his ulti here. The body slam, nice. The flash. Misha still wants a piece of that.
That's how you use the mastery.
Oh my god.
Well done, Misha. Well done.
Welcome.
At least he didn't flash Q ult and then miss. That would have been.
Wait, does Misha really have a clan with his own name?
So that is the case. So does Nemo.
It's true.
In fact, Nemo's whole team for the tournament today was all in that clan. They used that tag. The tag Nemo.
Maybe I need my own tag.
Yep.
A
big Nemo tag.
That's enough letters.
Yeah.
You get what? Five letters? Crepe works too.
Crepe does work as well. I don't think I want that though.
There's also Ender. Ender works.
Yeah, but he doesn't play League of Legends.
Danky works. I think Dave is level 19. It's not even.
He's trying to get that young burst.
That young burst kill
onto Jen. I don't know what
that
I was.
That sounds
say.
Very predatory.
Young burst
in a Chris Hansen kind of way.
Okay. Dragon number two goes over to green. I like that we're seeing Graves succeed. I like Graves.
Oh, there's a Shockwave X. Tempest is the only one to get tossed around like a circus. He's going to be able to actually get away from this. There's the curtain call. Lots of damage in the back line. TP comes in from the young alligator finding his home in the river.
I don't know why he completed that.
I'm not really
Sion
sure
now has free time at the tower.
There's nothing, no dragon. What? You're going to push a wave that's pushing against you to get the bottom turret? Sick memes, bro.
Yeah, but you're just going to end up trading because Gragas or Sion's on top of it.
Oh,
nice
Benva.
Nice.
Unless green engages here for some weird reason. They're going to dive this. But they are too afraid. Oh, there's the cast. No body slam to boost. Sivir presses that button way too late. Gray's going in, but the body slam's gonna stop that shot. Renekton picks that one up clean and clear like the face wash. Yak almost gonna get knocked up.
Oh, Tempest is
that's
1
really
HP.
Close. Gragas is here. Body slams Peter Lelol in the face. And they're gonna continue to chase. Ooh, Peter Lelol. Oh, Yak is gonna find himself in a little bit of an uncomfortable position, aka dead. And they will get that bottom lane turret.
You could say that's a little uncomfortable, yeah. Oh, that's the explosive team fight we were looking for.
I told you they were gonna dive. They had no rounds in the chamber and they were just loading up.
Yeah, they did lose
up.
Top tower.
They were playing Russian roulette with themselves.
And that's the issue with this LeBlanc is that you can't just like go for a double right in front of you. It's so obviously.
Oh my god, that was disgusting! But it was cleaned up by LeBlanc. Gray's in the back there looking for something else, but they're gonna be on the. Oh, Sion! Oh my god, where did he come from? That's gonna be a lot. Oh, Demonic Room actually shuts down. Will he turn it around? No, he won't. The Apple turnover will get absolutely obliterated. And will Gold. Ruby, rather, get out of this one alive. Looks like they'll be safe, but Gray's gonna cut them off. He's got the second distortion. One, here we go. Boop. Nope, he finds the pink ward.
Find a pink. Clear
gets,
that.
Gets spotted out. That was a close one.
Call it. That's all for. That's all. Folks.
Wait, Sion's only got an item and a half? What's going on?
Zion's sitting on 3,000 gold in his inventory.
Oh, that's what a
that's
god.
What's going on.
What a god.
I'm going to TP bottom lane instead of, you know, buying items.
He bought a frozen heart and a cowl. He doesn't need boots. Who needs boots?
Yeah, who needs boots when
he
you
already
have
has
the
boots
on
his train. Yeah, you got Thomas the Tank Engine running through the six. I actually really like the six. I want to join that club. But
I mean,
I'd rather not talk about
it. That's cool. I was the player.
Oh, okay. At least we're in the same boat. I'll invite you to see me.
I mean, I'm already a part of RU.
Oh, shit. That's dope. That's dope. I mad respect. RU Esports. Let's go.
Let's go.
Hype up my own.
This LeBlanc has picked up a couple kills in that last team fight to the point where she like might start being relevant.
But that dark seal though.
Four whole stacks. You know how much AP that is?
A whole 3.5.
27 whole AP.
Holy.
It is 3 AP per stack. Stack of 4 AP. But you know what? If you get a Rabadon's, that's an extra.
Oh, my spicy. But they're waiting for the flank. Renekton does have not. Oh, the shockwave, 10%, a little bit of trouble. There's the turnaround ultimate. Blue, the shield's up, but will it be enough to survive? No Neil, 1-3, 1-3. We'll get that curtain call. Opens up a brand new world.
Put on your juice.
Grace looking.
Nice tank by Janna.
Gray was looking for the pick, but wasn't able to get it.
Nice to see Janna tank that. Perfect execution.
Egg.
Why? That's the bad pun, because she's not an egg. She's the,
it's true.
The sorceress of the wind.
Oh.
I know. A temperature temptress.
Wow.
I don't know.
Oh.
I don't know.
You know, all you need to do to get out your bad pun woes is say, Peter Lelol.
Peter Lelol.
That's all you need to get out the bad pun woes.
Pita.
Peter Lelol is going for the Baron.
Very aggressive Baron play. And there's no blue trinkets on the rest of these. Oh my god, they're going to get them. Blue trinkets have blue trinkets. They have no reason.
Wow.
No way to check it.
So late. Peter Lelol with the call.
Yes, great call.
By Peter Lelol.
It could have been. Yes. Absolutely.
What is he building? Very curious.
Peter Lelol.
Peter Lelol, what are you doing?
He's building a Phantom Dancer.
Mm. Interesting.
Really, really good. I really like it.
Oh, great. What you doing, man? Oh, he's going back for that ward. Sneaky little bugger. Cheap. And now they go for Baron. Wow. Caught in rotation. What is Ruby doing? They can totally win these fights. They have the skills. They have the potential.
They have the skills. They have the item breakpoints as well. Peter Lelol.
Peter Lelol. But what they don't have is Peter Lelol.
they do. Oh, no.
No Peter Lelol for Ruby. Oh, Ray wants something, but there's the body slam. Barrage turns around, but Neil will store back as Sempress. He's gonna body block as much damage as he can. Ooh, Gray is just constantly missing these chains. And ooh, but the ignite did go out onto Neo. He was able to survive the rotation from Sion and Renekton. They're like running side by side together. Oh boy, Benva in a little bit of trouble. He's actually taking a lot of damage. Peter Lelol picks up that one. And Peter Lelol is going to continue to tank more damage under the turret. Here comes Renekton, the big man on campus. He's going to tank up four members of the squad. Yak first. Jesus, this is an absolute slaughter of the lambs here in the bot lane. Misha Swamp is the only one left alive.
Flash onto the back line. Something unlucky.
People are taking the accent. The banana is Victor Lelol. Look at this guy. He's getting... Oh, that was nice. Oh, but Gray's going to turn it around. No, he's not.
They need a better ball delivery system than Gragas has been in the game. If they can get a good shockwave, then it's... This game is unacceptable.
There was an opportunity there. They were all grouped, all four of them, targeting Renekton, but I think he used shockwave at that point. Shockwave is that spell that you gotta hold until that, like, just... Like, you know that meme, just right, when the guy's holding his fingers like this?
Yeah.
He's just... Just right, Sean.
I am familiar with such a meme, indeed. Good sir.
They're not gonna give blue to Oro. Oh,
I mean, I guess it's fine. You should be giving it to Oro. Gragas doesn't need it. Gragas has a hunting potion. Orianna should be getting it. I think that's a huge mistake not giving it to her.
Wow. Okay. So what happens when you build armor?
Against the wall with three items.
This is looking like it's really going to be tough for Ruby to come back from this. I thought they had like a pretty decent advantage, but I guess like...
They did, but
I guess Green started scaling, right? Did Green start scaling? Renekton wasn't there.
A couple of misplays.
And
mistiming. And.
Oh, Peter Lelos! Stuck between a rock and a hard Gragas. Lots of damage to the shockwave, but Janna gonna monsoon all her homies and boys back up. There's a lot of HP bars still on Green members, but one for one so far. Gray is still alive. Sivir getting a 2-for-1 special for $24.99 at Pizza Pizza. Jin gonna finish off Janna. Sion in the front line doing what he can. So far, 2-for-2 exchange. Gray gonna do what he can and picks up Misha with the champion master.
Threading the needle with that chain. Really nice chain play by Gray there. And to get that trigger on the halted.
The fact that both carries are still alive is good news.
Neo very nearly cleaned up the whole thing, but unfortunately wasn't quite strong enough to quite have enough AD and up lucky crits to make that.
What a game. You know, I think I might have to give this game to Peter Lelol. Peter Lelol has been playing out of his mind as well.
He's been playing pretty well, you're right. I also like that he went Death Stance. I really like this Graves build. The advantage of his end to Death Stance. It's like hard.
I also can respect anyone who's got a fun name to say. So far we got Super Super and Peter Lelol.
Is Super Shredooper, did they win MVP of their game? I don't think so.
Gragas? Why would he use Explosive Barrage there? Very preemptive. He was able to get out. Now that's a huge summoner. That's a huge spell that's gone.
Oh, his ulti. Yeah.
For this next fight. Why would you think?
Is he lagging?
Curtain call. Here's the huge fight. Ball delivery system will it work? Shockwave still hasn't been used. Zipper falling dangerously low. Gonna have to stay in the back of the fight. There's a shockwave hit one member. This game is over. Pasta a la Gigi Habib. X-Temper's falling a little bit, you know, safe. Gray is just, they're, Green is just styling on Ruby right now. This is gonna go to a game two. This is definitely...
Yeah, this is
game arena.
As they say, pasta Alex.
Oh my god, Misha.
When I say they, I mean... Oh, actually, they got those long. They get Peter Lelol!
No, this is when Sion just stands at the Nexus. Like, even if he dies, he gets...
They got Peter Lelol.
Peter Lelol.
The unkillable.
Ladies and germs.
You gotta warn me next time. I'll sit up first.
That was quite the game.
That was a game. That was a game. Congratulations to Green for taking game one. We'll be heading into game two shortly.
We're just going to take a quick five-second break.
Stretch. Get a glass of water, maybe.
Damage. Wow, look at that damage arena.
Mm-hmm.
When Peter Lelol out damages the AD carry, you know Peter Lelol's doing some good stuff.
He played a hell of a Graves that game. Well done. Very well played. I guess I'll give player of the game to Peter Lelol.
Peter Lelol. That's good stuff, guys. That's good stuff. We'll cash in a few as we set up this next lobby arena. But don't you go anywhere. Keep your butts in those chairs, and we'll see you in a bit.
Ladies, gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back. Welcome back. Simo's a little bummed because Cloud9 is losing at the moment, but that's okay. Because Cloud9's going to win eventually. It'd be good, buddy. We're heading into game two of the grand finals. Let's just get us over to the champion select screen. Sides have been swapped, so that means Ruby on the blue side.
The Renekton ban, will we see it come out from Peter Lelol? Lissandra.
Italy, Syndra, Kassadin. Lissandra. So far, they're identical. Victor. So far, Ruby's bands are the same,
still.
And Xerath's bands are the same. Or Xerath's bands are the same. Ruby and Green both banning the exact same champions.
The these casters are in love with Peter Lelol. It's a fun name to say, dude. You should just whoa, look at that who will win percentage. That's lots of Cloud9 fanboys on the hype train. It's a fun
name.
They're not as hype as Peter Lelol.
Always
playing.
They're
swapping
picking
junglers.
The graves away from Peter Lelol because he gets so much pressure on that in the early game. And really did a great job.
For those of you that are just joining us, Team Red, aka Green, is in the lead with a one game advantage. This best of three series. If Red Side wins this game, then we are all going home. But if Blue Side, aka Ruby, comes out with the clutch, we will be going to a game three, ladies and gentlemen. And I'll get another hour to say beat the Lord.
Hour?
Super game board. Hey, Cloud9 First Blood, let's go, baby. Sorry, I'm just
he's bumped by his
bumped.
Team.
I think Immortals will 3-1 Cloud9. Even me being a Cloud9 fanboy, look at this turnaround. Immortals just like is styling on him. Well, it's actually 1-1. They're not styling on
him. Yeah, that's not styling.
Anyhow.
Cloud9 has a gold lead.
Jinx Karma. For the side of Misha Swamp.
I like that lane. I think it's a good lane.
Ooh, shit. Wow. Shen into Renekton? Because that's probably what it... Oh,
is Demonic Kimura going to switch it up?
Oh, my God. No. Oh. No, he's going to meme and pick Renekton. He's going to meme and pick Renekton.
Is that a meme?
Renekton probably wins against Shen. Guaranteed.
Renekton would win against Shen, so would Gragas, or so would Graves, rather.
Stop banning
Syndra,
he's gonna play Ledank again, told you, same bans. Yeah, I know, but I think it would have been, like, hilarious to ban out Renekton, don't you think? Like, he plays good. Then again, it wasn't good enough to win last game. So his team is gonna need him to play
something
more.
That's the thing, if he picks up this LeBlanc, the one, like, really strong counter to LeBlanc is that Syndra. But that's banned out. So will we see Misha Swamp picking up the LeBlanc, or is it going to be Ahri Lock-In?
Have to
switches
ban
into Orianna again.
Have to ban Nexus of Syndra. Kid is a monster on
Gnar. Unless you first pick Syndra and Orianna.
Unless you first pick Syndra. There's the LeBlanc again.
I mean, last game, Misha solo killed.
You know what I think about this Gnar pick? This guy's been playing Renekton the entire tournament. Maybe. We haven't seen anything. But watching the H2K versus Splice game, I feel like Renekton is just so hard to play. I feel like Gnar is so hard to play. Like, if your bar is not ready for a fight, you guys ain't winning.
That's the thing, is that he's not necessary. That's the thing that makes Gnar such a great pick, is that you can use him in the split push to 1v1, because he's a really good healer. And when he's in Mega Farm, when he's an excellent team fighter, when he's in Mega Farm, he can kind of do both well in either form. Obviously, his team fighting is better when it's Mega Gnar, but he can still relatively effectively do all of it.
This is like a similar picking ban, but first kill. What did he play last game? Janna? Yeah, first kill played Janna.
First kill played Janna last game, and
now
he's playing
Karma.
Karma. Whereas
into Janna Jinx.
Yeah, so it's Janna Jinx.
It's gonna be tough for Jinx and Karma. It's gonna be tough.
No, sorry, Karma Jinx versus Janna Jhin. Whereas last game it was Janna Sipper.
Janna Jhin definitely have the upper hand. Jhin is just such a strong laner.
Yeah, Jhin is really
strong. And Jinx needs to get going, so this is going to be tough.
Yeah, basically you just need to, like, camp the crap out of the Jhin, because, you know, a low-mobility champion like that with no escapes.
We'll see if Benva picks up on it, though. As funny as it would be, Misha's Redick on those three champs. Much better than any others. I feel like you could let the Lissandra slip. What do you think? Do you think that's a
I think Lissandra, if played properly, has too big an impact in games.
Whenever I play Lissandra, I do no damage. Isn't her scaling super garbo?
Her scaling is pretty garbo, but her utility is absurd.
You know what I'm saying?
Pretty
like,
garbo. You're right. Her scaling is not great.
Oh, man.
And her damage is pretty limited. But she has that spicy Blade Mistress skin. Love that.
Is that green one?
Yeah.
I have that green one.
It's real nice.
I only busted out in ARAMs.
I don't know. Making a big play on Lissandra is...
Maybe I would have let the Zerath through. Because then you... Like, if you let the Zerath through and you force Misha to pick it, you pick an all-in comp and you just dumpster him because he can't run away. Zerath is like the lowest mobility fucking mid laner ever.
Mind your lips, boy.
Listen.
Bait
Misha into picking Zerath and pick something like Nautilus and just dumpster the fool, dude. Like,
pick something like Nautilus. Yeah, pick a bunch of like point and click CC champions. Pick like Nautilus, Warwick.
Malzahar in the mid lane.
Yeah. Oh my god. Malzahar mid, Warwick jungle, Nautilus top. Nautilus roams down mid like 1,000 times.
Man. Misha. That would be hilarious.
Oh my goodness. Wow. Yeah, that would be actually infuriating.
And then you play like Trundle support to knock him up out of the ulti all the time or to block off corridor so Misha can't run away. He's stuck fearing his life.
A Nivea support. That's what I would pick. Dude, Nivea support, my favorite.
If you can win Nivea support. Like, if you can make it to the finals and your team lets you play support and you play Nivea support and you win, I'll personally give you $200.
I guess I'm enrolling in the next.
I'm shaking on this, dude.
You see it here first.
You see it here. If he wins with the Nivea support in the finals, like, $200 is his. And that's like more than you would get if you came in first. Anyways.
Yeah.
So technically, if you risked it, you would get $200 if you guys placed second. Oh, wait, no, the condition is you have to win, right? Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because I was like, if you lost, like, you would only get, like, you would get, like, more money than you could, like, placing second.
Indeed.
You just swap junglers. This is hella annoying.
So, Peter Lelol on Gragas?
Yeah.
I like the Shen and Gnar. I'm really looking forward to...
Lissandra has sick ratios? Mm-mm. Isn't she the lowest scaling mid laner as far as ratios are concerned?
No.
I don't think she's that high.
No, she's so short range. That's why.
Oh.
That's why her damage falls off so much, because you have to get right in the middle. Oh, wow. They're going for a cheeky play.
The juke. She just checked. Shen is staying there. Interesting.
I mean, it is Shen's side of the map, after all.
Why not play Renekton? I'm still. Maybe he just. They need a team.
Honestly, Gnar is so good into Shen. Wow. And if you're good at it,
minions have
why
spawned.
Not play it? In my opinion. But that's just like my opinion.
Yeah,
man.
Like you're just like a caster, and like so am I. But like opinions are endless.
I mean, I'm supposed to be an expert. I am an expert.
Yeah, the play-by-play is never the expert. He's the memer.
And he's just a guy who gets really loud.
Oh my god, they're doing Krugs! Oh my god, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. There's the Q coming out from Karma. They're going to get these Krugs fairly low. The biggest Krug is actually going to be taking the most damage. The teammate's actually far away. The smite goes down. Graves actually picks up these two Krugs. That's two for nothing.
Did you just
red team,
play the Krugs?
Red team has no Krugs. Blue team has all the Krugs. Krug life. Then your support picks Morgana and Zerath runs away from the game, friends. Alt F4 is the way to go. I wonder if this is a first time Gnar. We'll see if Monica Ruma.
A good Gnar is very good. We saw Wonder today in the EULCS. We saw Wonder today playing Gnar and completely decimating all over his opponent. Crazy play. Really, really impressive. But then again, something tells me Monica may not be quite as good.
He's got the basic Gnar skin. When you got the basic Gnar skin, that you don't have no loyalty to Gnar, you know? No skin.
Yeah, but he's got the
no
loyalty
skin.
To the next in.
No skin equals no loyalty. You know, Gray has got a LeBlanc skin. He's got that loyalty. He's like, this Shen player, Shen skin. He's got that loyalty.
He does.
But the only thing this Jin has got loyalty to Jin, but no skin.
First kill doesn't have a karma skin.
True, that's karma.
Jin doesn't have a... Yak doesn't have a Jin skin. Granted, all the Jin skins are terrible. I mean, there's only one, but it sucks. In my opinion. But that's just like my opinion.
If you're entitled to it or whatever, right? I heard that somewhere. Look at this. Look at this.
Oh! Lenlol winning the.
Lenlol giving back the skull from a back rub.
Yeah, Benma has been struggling a little bit. This series.
Wow.
Some unlucky plays.
Misha has to recall.
Early game.
Gonna recall against LeBlanc. That's
for the double doors. Interesting.
First kill needs to be a little bit more aggressive here. He might have to just move up a bit.
Oh yeah, Karma should be really, really ragging on in lane, but instead she's just hitting the minions, the backline.
I mean, like, how is she expecting to get the first kill when she's not even, like, up there, dude? Peter Lelol! Ooh,
hey,
Ramana Karuma!
Get that other auto attack
from
the hyper rush.
Oh, there's that taunt. Let's go, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, he actually turns into Megan Arm. The flash does come out. The body slam will connect. There it does! And there's the cask. Oh, my goodness gracious, golly me. Ramana Karuma makes it out and lives
and
to tell
out
the tale.
Of there. Didn't quite play that properly. You always want to prop that third. Auto attack. A little burst.
Oh man, Karma, there you go. Atta girl. Get it done. Peter Lelol just beat himself
nice.
There.
Damage, yeah. It's like, you know what? Screw it. We're running it down mid, boys.
Wow.
This game's over.
Yak is just styling on Karma with the return pokes. I hope Peter Lelol has to get a follow-up.
Something tells you you can probably Google Peter Lelol.
Peter Lelol. You can ask some fans in the chat. Look at this guy, Not Sorello. Solero. There we go.
Not Solero.
Let's go, Peter.
Let's go.
C9's, they're even. It's like you can't even really. It's gonna be like who throws first.
Who throws first? Because we know they both will. How's Fink doing on that ribbon pick?
He's 2-0
and 2. Oh, he's 2-0 and 2. Oh, jeez.
Yeah, but Gangplank's 2-2. He's only.
Gangplank will definitely have skin.
Yeah, but Riven can 1v1 everyone, so they're gonna have to. Anyways, wrong game.
Yeah, but look at the shit.
Kind of Shen do? He can teleport on the whole. Shen is like the ice cube of this generation. Like he's just he's a real dude. He's a real OG dude. He's the backup. Shit goes, shit hits the fan. He's the power core. Oh, first kill. We're gonna get first kill with.
We're gonna get first killed it indeed, my friend.
I think that's what his name means. Like, he is the first one. Demonic Ruma. Hello? Gray. Oh, what the. Wow. Talk about
Chuck. Every time Misha goes for this aggressive trade, he's gonna send the ball first.
Oh, Peter Lelol making a return appearance in the top lane. Well, looks like that's gonna be a curtain call. Gonna have to come to the next week's show. Gonna get Haruma in time, but he's just waiting in the wings, hoping to fly, and there's his opportunity. Peter Lelol making his way, no cask, level 5. Feels bad.
That's feels bad, man. You're absolutely correct.
When you want a gank, but you're only level 5.
Wow, it looks like Mika is really having a hard time here today.
Came here for the games, stayed here for the dank memes. We're actually doing something.
Hey.
Maybe we got a meme every cast. I think that's the key to these people's hearts. If you just top Keck, look, you just they stay.
Thanks for coming out, Banana.
Thanks for thanks for coming. You were a top Keck master, man. Grandmaster Keck. You know,
it's like a
They swapped junglers, but they're less impactful in these positions. Neither of them have made a move. But Benva, cosplaying as Peter Lalol, comes in for the Janna kill. The rocket will connect. There's the flash. Empowered Q and the heal. First blood going over to the Peter Lalol cosplayer. But the real Peter Lalol is making his way here. He's got the barrage. Feels amazing,
the
man.
Shen.
There's the Shen that comes
special
in. Neo
delivery.
Fails to choose the right pill in the Matrix selection. There's the curtain call. Peter Lalol is falling dangerously low. Manages to fall to
Peter
the cosplayer.
Die to the Matrix. Unfortunate.
What a three for one exchange. That is what you call a steal. How many times have you gone into a store and gotten three items from the price of one? Never.
That's not necessarily true. It's great for what deal.
Except Canada, I've never seen one here. Oh, baby, yak. Oh, the juke, but it wasn't exactly the right
there
direction. Misha gets Yak, and her next target is NS Crafting, but Jan is there to spice things up. The tornado just hits the toenails of Misha Swamp, but Gray.
That flash is really unnecessary, Gray.
They ignited too.
I mean, you know, like, you got the kill and you kind of snowball. I respect it, but I don't think you necessarily need flash. I'm loving all the lulls and XDs in our chat right now.
Yeah, man, I'm just hee-heeing all the way to the bank. Ooh, Peter Lalol, cleaning up red buff. It's important to keep our eye on Peter Lalol, so we know what he's capable of. He's a monster in disguise as Gragas.
But Benva also,
a monster.
Has a bit of a lead for himself.
I mean, he's cosplaying as Peter Lalol on the grave. Are you sure Gnar beats Shen? Are you sure?
He should be beating Shen.
Are you sure, dude?
Yeah. Kite the hell out of him. But then you get, you know, taunted, and then whatever.
Oh, baby. Here's the collapse, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Third auto attack, Brock. Thanks for champion design. Oh, but the barrage is going to separate the fight. Monokuma. Pushing up against the wall. Wow, that's a sneaky Q. That was right between.
Absolutely.
Man, that like sounds good. Copyrighted, stolen. Your punch?
What the hell? What the hell? Oh, it's a Monokuma. He's big boy Gnar.
There we go. Gets the stun. I'm surprised. Oh my god, there's a
I'm surprised by the fact that Dramana Kuruma is just kind of like, alright, I'm just gonna walk in there. But I can
The reverse, like, that was a DJ Khaled, you played yourself. Congratulations.
You played yourself.
Oh, Benva, looking for the flex.
He's got his ulti, but it's not gonna kill Shen. He has flat, he doesn't have flat.
I'm really interested
if he dashes in. Gets a couple autos.
Oh, Misha. Looks like
dead here.
Oh, looks like Gray is adapting to this matchup. You feel me? It's like he's adapting to this matchup. Like last
game, his first game was pretty shaky. This game he's been very, very solid. He's like, you know what? I want to go home. I'm done with this. I've been playing League of Legends all day, and as much as I love
$2
the
pizza
that is this game.
$2 pizza, $5 monster. Like, it's tough out here.
Hard out here. Damn.
Nice. I wish we had a crowd. We could clap on that board. Monokuma, will he get the third auto? Auto.
Percent HP damage.
Oh. Peter Lalol stealing some camps.
Once the Monokuma gets himself that frozen mallet, he should actually be a bit of a menace.
Dennis?
Yeah.
Oh, that third
Ooh,
auto.
The auto.
Man.
What a skillful League of Legends
what a
player.
PIMP, dude.
Mother hecking PIMP.
Oh, I do. Oh, I thought you tanked for it though. Oh, looks like this is gonna be interesting. Engage X Empress in a little bit of trouble. The tornado comes out. There's the rocket, but will it pop it? No, it won't.
Oh,
but
there it
Benva
is.
With the cleanup janitor duty. The body slam not gonna do a whole lot, but Peter Lelul is in a little bit of trouble now. The barrel gonna slow them around. Misha Swamp gets pushed around like
a
rag.
Very little communication on this team, because this is now twice in the bottom lane that I have seen people, more than one person, flash to secure a kill after the kill has already been secured. If you're going to flash, try and secure a kill, be like, hey guys, I'm flashing. Or if you can secure it, say, hey guys, I got it.
Oh, great.
It's like playing volleyball.
Great. A little bit of a gray area.
A dead area.
Uncomfortable position, aka dead.
sick memes, love it. Some unlucky one.
I really didn't want to see Gnar's brother in this game. AKA Young Blood.
Is that Gnar's brother?
I don't know. He looks
Gnar's like pretty slow.
Yeah, but like.
Gnar's an old boy.
Blood's maturity is like pretty slow too. Oh, looking for the kill onto Yak. Will they get it? There's the chain, but will it connect? Yak! What was that? Neo, this is not the Matrix, buddy. Let's chill out, dude. Lag?
Lag?
Lag? Hello?
Yes, I'm lagging.
Hello? Pause? Pause?
Okay, I'm back.
Crack.
Sorry, guys, I was lagging.
Oh no, Demonic Kuruma. Oh, he mad. You don't like John Cena when he mad. Here's the knockup. There's the stun. Push him around. Now it's right, done.
The
I'm
Q,
a rapper.
Man.
Don't forget.
Don't miss the Q.
Demonic. Ooh, wow. This guy put up champion.
He put
master.
It up before he even.
Oh,
went
look
in
at the Jukes. Here's Juke
kill.
City, Resident Shen, and Gragas.
He's got the hop. He's got it.
Third auto. Let's go, baby. Oh,
hop
third
it.
Auto again. Let's go, baby.
He's got
Is
it.
That him? Is that the kid? No, because he's an adult. It's the kid.
Holy moly.
He broke some ankles. We're going to need some doctors at the Invictus Game Station stat, ladies and gentlemen.
This is the second game in a row where Ruby has secured first break, by the way. So if they've got nothing else going for them, they've got that.
They've got the classic.
And this Gnar, that was some fancy feat right there. See,
Demonic
that's
Ruma.
The power of the mini Gnars. The kiting is crazy. If he had Frozen Mallet in that, maybe.
I do have to say, though, on a serious note, very serious, they're going to have to figure out a way to deal with Gray.
They really are.
That's the biggest
and
problem.
I think the best thing to do so would be get yourself an Aegis as soon as you possibly can on Karma and stack as much MR as you can.
Like, it's not going to be, you're not afraid of Peter Lelol. You're not afraid of Yak. You're not afraid of NS Crafting, you're afraid of Gray.
NS Crafting and Peter Lelol. Peter Lelol also all do magic damage. Like, most of Shen's damage is magic damage.
Frozen Mallet completed.
There you go. And the merchants. That's actually huge.
Young Gnar in the cut. Oh, he's ready.
So he's
like,
hey.
Oh, he ready. You ain't running, baby.
I'm angry.
You ain't running, baby.
You won't like me
off,
when
baby.
I'm angry.
Oh, baby.
And there he is. And you can see with a Champion Mastery 4 on Gnar. So he's clearly.
Yeah. Oh, curtain call a little early. The show hasn't even begun, but great. Oh, that's explosive. Misha's going a little
swamp,
bit balls.
Flashing
Neo in the Matrix
shockwave.
Doing what he can to kite Gragas, but it's not going to be enough. Misha's still alive. What's going on? Double kill going over for Gray. The 2-for-2, 2-for-3 special. Demonic. Oh,
unlucky.
Hello? Lag? Hello?
Benva? How'd you do that?
Mia, where's...
nice, dude.
Hey.
Good job.
Where's Mia?
I mean, that was just a full-blown 5v5. There's no Mia necessary.
Jungler, where were you, dude? TP, though?
Yeah, he probably shouldn't. He probably should have gone top. You don't need his help to get this tower. Although it would be nice to have, I guess, some tank that dragon for him.
By the way, I'm not really sure what's going on, but it looks like Cloud9 is winning in objectives, but Immortals is winning in, like, mind games. I'd go for the objective. Yeah. Oh, this is the Dragoon. Will Peter Lelore steal it once again? Gray! Oh my goodness gracious! This is spicy. Gray is just an absolute monster. Here we go. Shen's off to the side. Demonic Kuma's in a little bit of trouble. He's got the funk, but does he got the moves? No, we don't. They need to figure out how to deal with Gray. They need it, like, Gray is popping first kill every time. He's the first kill of, like, their team. He's always the first to die. He's the first kill.
That's what he's aimed for. He's the support. He's supposed to die for.
It's true. Oh. Chana with... Oh, baby. They want it. Oh, they're going to get it. Ex-Tempress. That's not going to save you against close. Oh, the rocket. Boom. Kaboom. Gray. Ooh. The curtain call. Will she be able to score back? Oh, my goodness. Venma's still alive. Holy moly. Quacker moly. And it's grabbing a little bit of trouble. The curtain call is going to finish. But here's the huge shockwave. Going to get two people up. There's Gnar. Oh, Peter Lilo still alive. Holmes. Oh my god, Gnar is actually going to get the pickup on the Gragas, but Gray is going to chase down these two last members. Graves is off to the side, but he's dangerously low, but the Q will connect. There's the second Q. The passive will proc mirror image, but which one's the real one, Holmes? Congratulations on the pickup. Green is going to get a 2-for-1 special.
2-for-1 special, indeed.
Now, Baron call with the support and ADC. Let's go. Don't need a tank. Let's
go. Yeah, Janna and Jin can solo the Baron at 19 minutes before it even spawns, right?
Yeah, dude. Oh, 40 seconds. They're ready.
Easy peasy.
Preemptive Baron.
Easy peasy lemon.
Wait, is there already a Baron? No. That's just spawning. That's Rift Herald.
That's the first one. Rift Herald.
Yeah.
Baron doesn't spawn until 20 seconds.
Yeah, I'm right.
Same dude.
Caster like. Commentating the intro. Nope. How did Demonic Kuruma get knocked up there? Oh, the tornado. Tornada.
Man and a woman.
Oh, here we go. Peter Barrage. Peter Lelol is on the chase. Blue's clues. Demonic Kuruma is actually pissed. He's so mad. Gets the barrage. But you don't want to do that. Oh, baby. Gray's in the back room turning it. Oh, my God. Let's go. Double kill. Go triple kill going over for Ruby. And that's by far my favorite Pokemon game. If you didn't catch the hint, all these team names are Pokemon names. But let's fucking go, bud. Let's go.
What?
What a play.
Like when they stop. Become the ultimate hoser.
Hi. Let's fucking go there, bud.
Gray.
You need
all
some
right.
Tims. You need some Tims. Where's the French vanilla, bud? Gray hasn't died yet. That's a problem. 14 stack mage eyes. We need to solve this issue right now.
And you know what's a great way to solve that issue?
Dying.
Kill his ass.
Kill his ass. They don't have lockdown. They can't lock him down. That's the problem.
I mean, yeah. I mostly chain CC him with Gnar and trap and stuff.
When Kanye West composed Love Lockdown, he had Gray in mind because you just couldn't love lock him down, dude. You couldn't. You couldn't.
When he composed.
Because Kanye West.
When Kanye West was like being pretentious and probably stoned.
Kanye West composer Kappa. Big word.
Kanye West, best artist of the year.
Yeah, dude, he's a millennial genius.
Oh, get out. This is like the best final game. Oh, boy.
Alright. They won a team fight. They've caught up in gold. They're half a K down. They need to get Gray. And then they'll be in the lead. They'll win. They get Gray, they win. Who cares about Jin? They get Gray, they win. That rhymes. That's all you need to. That's all you need to remember.
Forget about Jin.
Who cares about Jin? Get Gray, you win. Forget about Jin. Get Gray, you win.
Sounds like a spell.
Yeah, dude. Because I'm casting a spell to help Ruby win.
Hey, get it? Because you're casting a spell. Get it? Because you're a caster.
Hehe. XD.
New team's turret. It's way too hard. Yeah, this is serious business.
This is like a highlight.
You know, actually, now that I think about it, the last tournament that I did, the 5v5 at Anime North, Wigger, also had Gray winning that tournament, previously known as Vance, won that tournament.
So, I actually casted the previous anime.
That's up.
There's like a huge crowd when you pass the league. Like semis had a huge crowd, but finals didn't have a huge crowd because everyone went to the raid. Like that's how long the games last.
Yeah, anime North is here. Oh, that big chunk on a Neo. Holy moly. Anime North this year was
worse, better.
It was very fun, but the last game ended up just for tonight.
That's tough. Damn, man. Yeah. Tough. I'm gonna get this channel's gonna get banned. Twitch terms of service.
I'm pretty sure Esports Canada TV is technically gaming.
Oh, right. They get that filter. Warning. Yeah, that filter, that warning.
So if you have an issue with the language, then
where are you from?
Yeah. Too bad.
Too bad.
Basically,
feels bad, man. Dragon Ocean Great. Yeah, Cloud9's having a. Oh, they got who?
That's it.
That's it. It's over.
They got only 35 minutes. Jensen's red though, so
that's nice.
Meanwhile, this game. Another Drake going over to the green team. Let me just mark that down.
Oh, they almost got Gray. They almost got Gray, dude. They almost got Gray. Oh, boy. Oh, no. First kill. Flash. Oh, no. Oh, this is dangerous. Oh, no. Oh, no. There's a flash. Oh, no. Wow, oh, but Gray? Gray? Gray's dead? Okay, they win the fight. They win the fight. Demonic Groove has arrived. Let's go, boys. This is the one. Yak is it. Oh, no. Double. Oh, no. Come on, Demonic. Come on, Demonic. You got this. You got
going
it.
Big. He's going big.
He's going big. He's going big.
Unlucky.
I guess he wanted to go home.
Just needed an unlucky. Look at Gray with the spam. The perfect opportunity for the spam. Man. Well done, sir. Well
go
done,
big or dude. Go home. Looks like Ruby decided to go home, dude.
Yeah, I think they're tired. This is way too cringe to watch.
Dude, we feel the same way, man. Not like this.
Whew. What a game. What a game. Swamp is a really, really good game. Played really well in the first game.
Because he's got
nine Orianna and ball. Nice one, dude.
I mean, I'd love for a game three, but right now the chances are like.
Yeah, it's not looking promising, I'm afraid.
Yo, dude, someone's defending our cringe. MVP, dude. Somebody mod him.
That
feels Bronze 5 Scrum. Let's go!
Oh, that's, man. Super duper rude. I really appreciate it.
Forget about Jin. Get Gray. You win. That's cool. Flame is lame.
Flame is lame. Absolutely correct.
All right. Demonic Kuruma. Oh my god. This curtain call every time. Holy. This barrage actually missed though. Where's Gray? Where's the shockwave? Press R. Press R. Where's. Okay. You got the R. There we go. There we go. But it did do it. Oh my goodness gracious. Gray is just styling all
that
over the place.
That Gnar is.
Oh my god, let's go, boys! Let's go! Oh no, it's done. It's
if
done.
they still have the shockwave after god. That Gnar hit, that's GG. Well, maybe not GG.
Oh my
that's
god.
Like,
wait,
guys, we're back
wait,
in the game.
Wait! You got a double kill onto Gray and Jin. That's actually spicy.
Oh yeah, the kite kills on Graves with as much lifesteal as he has right now.
Does he have sriracha sauce and his shotgun shells? Dude, that was spicy.
Yeah, you're right.
They can't even Baron off that, but Jinx is there. Jinx is there. Hello? Hello?
Clearing waves.
Oh, she should totally, like, poke back and forth. She can't let them get this blue. Should roll?
No. Also, I feel like she should
Janna gets blue? No.
I give it to Gragas.
Young Gragas.
Young Grey Goose.
We're young Grey Goose. Grey Goose going ham.
Why are you doing that from over the wall? That's how it resets, you dingo.
Oh my god, I can't believe Huni can't catch Meteos' Gragas. How does a Riven not catch a Gragas? I don't get it, dude. Meteos is a legend.
Because Meteos is a god?
Yeah.
Did you see the feature they did on Meteos?
No.
They did like a 3-man feature on Meteos before the series. It's on the
wait, there's a Baron.
the police buses.
Oh no, they got it. Oh yeah.
Smite.
Oh no, you better run, boy. Yeah, you better run.
The Deathfire touch.
That's GG.
Deathfire touch.
Is that GG?
27 minutes. That's definitely an issue.
That might be GG.
That also
is big. They could have a good.
I'm going in, Ma.
Oh no. Oh no.
Just kidding, Ma.
Oh man. Rest in peace, man.
Rest in peace.
Jesus. On the tombstone, you should write "Forget about Jim." That's 89 degrees. One Misha home. God.
Very good.
Karma should have like shielded it. That's a super tough game. Can you imagine casting an entire game with just
the only Twitch memes?
Bible thumb.
Some real feels bad, man.
That's
right
some
there.
Real feels bad. That's what we've been doing. Oh, Bible thumb.
Oh,
oh
baby.
No. Box jam. Oh, they got one. Box jam.
Oh, Shem.
Oh, no.
Got caught in the base. In the base.
Oh, man. I've got a real. Oh, great.
Oh, baby. That was
oh,
through
man.
A mom.
That, come on. This is a BG.
That was through a mom. Gray has 2,400 gold.
Shen tanked a four-man Jinx ult with three of them were there. To so that's because Shen has been learning from Peter Lelol. The Gregus Master, Peter Lelol. We got Tony coming in, checking in on the meme stream. Then the meme stream, yes. That is the name of the stream, meme stream. But update the title.
That's not.
Twitch TOS would be proud. Let's turn this to a.
Why would the TOS be proud?
Let's turn this into a social eating stream. Oh, gray! That's a gray area,
what are
buddy.
You doing?
Where you
you
at,
goon.
Bud? Oh, the rocket just whiffed.
That feel when the rocket whiffs.
Oh my god.
That feel when you're trying to catch a gray before rocket whiffs.
Yeah, man. That feel when you're just a color.
That feel when you're nothing but a color.
You're nothing but a color.
Unlucky.
Unlucky, man. You're just gray, dude. Like, you don't see skies of blue, you see skies of gray.
Yak, going for the curtain call.
Gray is late. Gray is late. Gray is late. The barrage?
Okay.
That's two ults done. Oh, here's gray. Party in Jamaica?
Yeah.
Vacation
oh,
Barbados?
Okay.
Oh my
Rich
god.
Pepperonis.
Oh my goodness. Then, oh, Bill, you stuff him and you drop him, but there's the shockwave.
Demonic?
Oh, demonic? No.
Just like kind of pop and scoop them right into the hands.
Oh, not like this.
Misha Swamp shockwave.
Not like this.
First kill.
Not
more
like this.
Last kill. More like can't kill. More
man.
Like hard two kill.
Oh no.
But this looks like a good game.
Not
yeah,
like
they
this.
They got super minions. They
not
got three,
like this.
Four.
Not like this.
Focus down the nexus, guys. Focus down the nexus.
Guys, come on. Don't be rude. Don't be rude. No. This is
Peter Lelol.
Yeah.
Here he's
I'm
going.
Reporting to the reporting to the just finish the nexus. Don't not no.
W.
Oh my god.
P.
Oh my god. Tilted.
GG, well played.
I hope you guys enjoyed the meme stream. I'm boosted AF.
Congratulations.
You played yourself.
To green.
You guys
being the solo queue summer hero champions.
You mean team green? You mean team gray, right?
Thanks for joining
where,
us.
Where's
on
Crumbs?
The stream
today. We need the prophet to tell us.
No, we don't want that. We really don't want that.
Well,
makes me cringe harder than
at,
you
at,
do.
At least Peter Lelol won. That's all that matters. Peter
Lelol. He did have a magnificent game on Gragas. 4-4-17.
Is that 100%? No, it's not. Not even close.
Not even close, baby.
No, nice, nice.
Talking about memes.
Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this meme stream.
Thanks for
We were kind of drained earlier today because some of the games were just like
Resident Sleeper.
But nevertheless, this game was PogChamp. These games were PogChamp.
Yeah,
AF,
PogChamp is yeah, PogChamp is heck, dude.
Dude, I you know, man, I want to make a meme so bad, but it's just too soon. It's too soon.
Thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for joining us. Congratulations to Team Green for winning the whole thing, for winning Worlds. They're the world champion now.
World champions of Toronto.
Have a wonderful evening. Go watch NALCS if you'd like to. And if you don't want to, then don't.
We'll catch you guys next time, possibly. Yeah.
Thanks
next
for hanging out. Oh, I'd just like to draw attention to something real quick, real spicy quick. Actually, I can't pull it up. But LeBlanc's KDA was 13-3-7.
Elite.
So, nice meme. Finish it off with a spicy meme. All right. What? Enjoy the rest of your evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining us. And we look forward to seeing you next time. Cheers. Go follow our Twitch streams. Excuse me. They're posted earlier in the chat. I'll post them again right now. There we are. And we are out. Thank you so much. Follow us on Twitter. Follow us on Twitch.
Peace.
And we're gone.
Peace, dude.
Have a wonderful evening.